Next one is exercise 2.10. In our question is a water fountain on the ground sprinkle water all around it. If the speed of water coming out of the fountain is V, calculate the total area around the fountain that gets wet. Now what is the problem says? A water fountain on the ground sprinkle of water all around it. That is taking circular motion. Then the speed of water is V. The speed of water is V. Okay. Then you calculate the total area around the fountain that gets wet. Since in the circular motion, undergoing the centripetal acceleration, you know very well, centripetal acceleration formula, G equal to V squared divided by R. So from this equation, I want to calculate R means, this equation become like this, R equal to V squared divided by G. Okay, now I will find the total area around the fountain that gets wet. That is, area of the circle formula what? Pi R squared. So instead of R, I will write V squared divided by G. So here pi into, instead of R, you will write V squared divided by G whole power squared. So here pi into V power 4 divided by G squared. So this is total area of around the fountain that get wet is equal to pi V power 4 divided by G squared. Next one is exercise 11. In our question is, the following table give the range of a particle when thrown on different planets. All the particles are thrown at the same angle with the horizontal and with same initial speed. Arrange the planets in ascending order according to their acceleration due to the gravity G value. So this is following table. So in this table, the planets are given as well as the range also given. Now what will happen? The range of the particle when thrown in different planet is given. Here all the particles are thrown at the same angle with the horizontal with same initial speed. Now you have to arrange the according to the acceleration due to the gravity. Now you have to find out the relationship between the range and the acceleration due to the gravity. For that, I am going to write the formula for range. So the range formula is R equal to U squared sine 2 theta divided by G. Here, according to their problem, all the particles are thrown at the same angle with the horizontal and with the same initial speed. So here angle and initial speeds are same. So this equation can be written as R inversely proportional to 1 by G. So here range decreased means what about acceleration due to the gravity? The acceleration due to the gravity increased. So from this table, here the range is very small. So here very small means, here what about acceleration due to the gravity? Very large, isn't it? So from this table, which is greater acceleration due to the gravity? Jupiter only. So here acceleration due to the gravity in Jupiter is greater than the acceleration due to the gravity in earth. Next, acceleration due to the gravity in earth is greater than the acceleration due to the gravity in Mars. Then acceleration due to the gravity in Mars is greater than the acceleration due to the gravity in Mercury. Okay, next one is exercise 12. In our question is, the resultant of two vectors A and B is perpendicular to the vector A and its magnitude is equal to the half of the magnitude of vector B. Then the angle between A and B is dash. Here, the resultant vector of two vectors A and B is perpendicular to vector A. Here, this is resultant vector. This resultant vector is perpendicular to vector A. So, this is perpendicular vector A. Vector A, this is resultant vector. Vector is R. Okay, and what about in B vector? B vector is in this direction. This is B vector. This is B vector. And the resultant vector magnitude is equal to, so the resultant vector magnitude is equal to half of magnitude of B vector, that is B divided by 2. B divided by 2, that is B vector divided by 2. Then the angle between A and B is, so here the angle between A and B, so this angle is theta what? So theta you will find out. You know very well this is make an right angle triangle. So here this angle is, you will take alpha. So here you know very well alpha plus theta equal to make an angle is the total angle what? 180 degree. First you will find out this alpha. Which alpha? Sin alpha. Okay, so here sin alpha equal to sin alpha equal to sin alpha equal to sin alpha formula what? Pa opposite side divided by hypotenuse. So here opposite side is B vector divided by 2 divided by in hypotenuse. Hypotenuse what? B vector, that is B vector divided by 2P vector. So here this vector cancel. So the result is 1 by 2. Isn't it? So here sin alpha equal to 1 by 2. Sin alpha equal to 1 by 2 means alpha value is 30 degree. So sin 30 degree value 1 by 2, isn't it? So here alpha value is 30 degree. So alpha value is 30 degree. Now this value substitute in this equation. So here alpha value is 30 degree. Theta value you will find out. So equal to 180 degree. So I want to theta means that side. So theta equal to 180 degree minus 30 degree. So the value is 150 degree. This is theta. So here the angle between A and B is 150 degree. So here C is a 150 degree.